Hello, my name is Zira, and I am from Microsoft USA. I will be taking over from David for this lecture, and read the notes for you as you go through the slides. Let's get on with it. Today you are going to deal with process variables, which are used to characterize a process. What is a process? A process can, for example, happen inside a chemical reactor, and is represented by a box in this diagram. An example of a transformation could be a chemical reaction, or the heating of a fluid. Continuous means that the same process is happening all the time as the plant runs 24 hours a day. A substantial scale means that a lot of material is handled every day. This is what chemical engineers are good at organizing. Amounts can be mass, in kilograms, or mass flow rate, in kilograms per second. These are two possible examples. Similarly, compositions can be mass fractions, or mole fractions, both of which do not have units. Also, conditions are things like pressure and temperature. Arrows will indicate where the material is entering, where it is leaving, and where it is in the process. So, for each of the feed, and the process, and the product, you need to be able to specify the amounts, compositions, and the conditions. What are process variables? You can either measure, or calculate, variables. You are going to learn more about these variables in this lecture.